sige. Ikaw na yun ang inquiry.
Ay, okay.
Sir, magandang gabi.
Good evening.
Ano pong agenda ang ipupush nyo dito sa ASEAN Summit? At bukod sa tatlong leaders na ka-bilateral nyo, yung Vietnam, Laos, and
Timor-Leste.
Meron pa po ba kayong ibang ka-bilateral?
So far, hindi. Yung palang naka-schedule. Kasi kung titignan nyo yung schedule, medyo masikip talaga eh. So, dinagyan namin. Kasi yung Timor-Leste is the first time na nandito sila sa ASEAN as observer status, which is a step towards becoming a member. So, yun ang kaya kailangan makilala natin. Vietnamese, Prime Minister, bago. Hindi namin nakilala sa nakaraang mga na ASEAN. Laos, Prime Minister, the same situation, bago. So, although the Vietnamese Prime Minister, nakilala ko sa London. Now that I mention it, nakilala ko sa London, but never mind. Para we'll go through the formalities. Ang agenda rito is to revitalize the economies. We've seen sa EU, we've seen sa ibang lugar, that the global economies are also turning towards Asia. And the reason is that perhaps we are adjusting better than the Western countries, the African countries, the Middle Eastern countries are also doing well. But tinitignan din ang Southeast Asia and ASEAN. And that's what the subject matter will be, is that how do we play the part that we want to play, which is going to be the global locomotive of the global economy. So I think all of those kind of aspects of that, yun ang pag-uusapan. Or at least in the Philippines case, yun talagang pag-uusapan natin. But I predict that we will have the same idea in mind. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Marami. Talagang gagamitin mo yung 1 year. Asahan nyo yun. By the end of the first year, para magigmaliwa. In a sense, tapos na yung OJT ng lahat ng tao. And we've seen who performs well and who is will be important to what we are doing. So, yes, there's really going to be, I don't know about reshuffle, but reorganization sa kabinete.
Thank you, sir. Catherine Valiente ng Manila Times.
Good evening.
Yeah. Well, parang inevitable eh, unavoidable yung subject matter na yun. Dahil pare-pareho na mga membro ng ASEAN, siyempre it is a grave concern to all the member states of ASEAN. So it's considering that we also agree on the concept of ASEAN centrality when it comes to regional concerns. That will be one of the most important subjects that we will bring up. So the discussions on that since that we had a year ago, close to a year ago, in that time, marami nang nagbago, many changes have occurred, and that's why we have to recalibrate whatever it is that we are planning to do. So yes, there's no way around it. That will inevitably be a part of the conversation that we'll be having tomorrow and the day after.
Thank you, sir. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN.
Hi. Sir, will you still push for the finalization of the Code of Conduct on the South China Sea, just like what you did with the Cambodia, was the chairman of the ASEAN? Kasi po last time, kayo po nagpanggit, wala naging progress.
Yeah, but okay, you cannot stop trying. So yes, I'll bring it up again, because when we talk about the issues in the West Philippine Sea, South China Sea, hindi magkakalma yan hanggang meron na tayong code of conduct. Kasi may code of conduct, lahat pasasusunod lahat. That makes things clearer. Walang possibility na magkamali, na kasi maliwanag na maliwanag dapat ang usapan. So yes, that has always for me been a key element in the ASEAN centrality solution of all of these these problems is really the new code of conduct. It, paulit-ulit ko lagi sinasabi, and every forum I can find, sinasabi ko, code of conduct, kailangan natin tapusin.
Thank you, Sir. Marie Somali, yeah. GMA7.
Yeah. We were also with you during the last ASEAN summit and the APEC summit, and you were also, of course, asking for the objective is also to find a conclusion to the code of conduct, but you were not able to reach it. Sir, what do you think are the challenges?
The challenges are because it gets complicated because the code of conduct would essentially be a multilateral arrangement, multilateral, I suppose you could call it a treaty, between ASEAN and China. And that's what the declaration that went before was, but now we need a new one. So the problem is that there are it gets complicated because there are bilateral arrangements between member countries and with China that have to be resolved, that we need to resolve so that we can have a common code of conduct. Because over the years, syempre, lahat nakikipag-usap sa China, yung iba sa ASEAN dumadaan, iba-ibang nangyayari. Kaya napaka-importante na maging maliwanag na may code of conduct, ganito yung gagawin natin. This is how we operate. Pag kami problema, dito natin i-resolve, etc. Yes, that's getting in the way. But more and more, again, siguro I'm the eternal optimist, pero I really believe that we will slowly, slowly get to the point where we can prefer and say this is what we want it to look like and this is what we think will be effective. On this summit?
Yes.
No, the code of conduct, the negotiations of code of conduct are separate from the ASEAN summits. They negotiate in another way. So that's not something that will be done here at this time. What we need to do is, look, if kung wala pa, ano pa talagang naging problema? This is what we have to discuss amongst ourselves. What is the problem? What is the bottleneck? Where are we having a hard time? How can we fix that problem? That's what these meetings should be for, and I think we'll get to that point, because everybody wants this to work. Everybody wants to have a code of conduct. So what's getting in the way? Let's talk about it. You know, iba-ibang bansa yan, and everyone has a different agenda. But if we talk about it, and with a common thought in mind, I think we'll get there. But I hope sooner rather than later. Because the tensions are increasing.
I'm sorry, one last. Sir, will you also give a self-imposed deadline on the talks with China with regards to the issue of fishing in the
Gulf of Philippines? No. The deadline is when it's done.
Okay.
Because if you set a deadline and it's not done, what then? Doesn't really help. It doesn't help anything. So just keep going as hard as you can, as much as you can, until you get an agreement on the fishing grounds. I've already spoken with our ambassador, and yun na nga, sabi niya, willing na kami, let's map it out, and that's what we'll have to do when I get back. Sinimulan na namin, I talked to the Coast Guard, I talked to the DFA, and I said, this is the proposal of the Chinese. Let's see if we can accommodate that into our agreement. So we're headed there. May progress na.
Thank you, sir. Ana Felicia Baho, GNO.
Yeah. Well, ganun pa rin. We haven't really stopped. Ganito, this is the impasse, okay? The impasse is that we continue to ask for a commutation or even a pardon or just an extradition back to the Philippines. And that is constantly there. But the Indonesians answer us, and it's that this is the law. Ito yung batas dito sa Indonesia. Kaya kailangan natin ipagpatupad yan. And they have already given us postponement of the, but that doesn't mean it's done. Well, I always at least bring it up. Na baka sakali magbago. Sa ngayon, ganun ang mga position natin. Is that yes, we agree, we understand that he is convicted. We understand that the law in Indonesia is that way. But nonetheless, baka makahanap tayo ng paraan, iuwi na lang namin yan. Kami na magpaparusa sa kanya, whatever. But anyway to ask for clemency, to ask for grace when it comes to this.
Thank you, sir. Last question. May lakad pa si Presidente. Helen Flores. Philippine Star.
Hi, sir. Hi, there.
Sir, did you meet British Prime Minister soon after the United Kingdom?
Yes. Well, this is the same thing that comes up every time I meet with leaders. Nagpapasalamat siya sa magandang trabaho ng mga Pilipino at Pilipina doon sa NHS nung pandemic. At kung pwede ba nating dagdagan, may kasunod ngayon. But also, but I basically discussed, we were talking politics, and I was saying that I was commenting that at least with his election as leader and now prime minister, well, magkaroon ng konting stability in the UK because medyo magulo. And we said, look, sabi ko sa kanya, there are many opportunities that we have had. In fact, yung kanilang trade representative accompanied me in Gatwick. And he reported to the Prime Minister that there is this proposal from the conglomerate. Well, the conglomerate we keep hearing about for the airport. That was why I went to Gatwick. That day, report niya, sabi niya, sana matuloy natin. Let's talk about it. And we won't be able to do it now because we had maybe 7 minutes, 6 minutes. We can't do it now, but we'll do a proper trip for you to come to the UK, and we'll talk about it soon. That's where we ended. We also met his wife, who kept talking about their mga governess ng kanilang mga anak, like everywhere you go. So, ang protocol doon sa reception, bawal mag-selfie. Eh, asawa naman siya ng Prime Minister, sabi niya, I'm going to violate the protocol because sabi nung kanilang kasambahay, ay huwag kang aalis dyan hanggang makakuha ka ng picture kasama ng Presidente namin. So inutusan nila yung Prime Minister at saka yung asawa, kaya nagpicture. Galing talaga ng Pinoy, no? How about the? Well, King's, yeah, it was very mahirap, very quick, but kasi dumadaan lang siya na ganun, but as you can imagine, he was very, very busy. But kahit papano, yun na nga, I just caught a few moments with him, kinamayan ko, nagpakilala ko. The minute he heard Philippines, sabi niya, it's terrible what you have to endure. All of these typhoons that climate change has brought, and sinabi ko nga sa kanya, yes, Your Majesty, you've actually been warning us about this for a very long time. So yeah, well, but nobody was listening. And then I said that I did not have the chance to come at the funeral of Queen Elizabeth. But please know that I wanted to extend, late as it is, my condolences. It was a great loss to all of us, even Filipinos who are not British. He came to love the Queen, especially those of us who spent time in England. And he thanked me for that. And I told him, I then went and said, my mother Imelda, pag Imelda, nakilala na niya. My mother, Imelda, when she knew that I was coming, wanted to send you her best wishes and congratulations for your coronation. And he said, how is she? Kasi kilalang-kilala niya talaga yan. Magkakilala talaga sila. Ako nakilala ko siya mga 2 or 3 times. Pero yung si mother ko talaga. Kasi mga foreign, siyang laging representative ng Reyna. Mami ko naman ang representative ng father ko. So, lagi silang nakikita ko saan-saan. And he said, well, give her my warmest felicitations. We had so much fun together. I said, well, congratulations on your coronation. It was very nice. He clearly knows about the Philippines. Marami siyang kaibigan na Pilipino.
Did you get invited, sir, to the Philippines?
Ay, nako. There was no time for that. Nagbabayuhan doon sa para makausap yung his mother. Well, yes, I did. It was, my gosh, it was historical. Yung parang, it was like a couple of centuries ago, no? Kinokoronahan ng hari. Kailan pa ba mangyayari sa buhay ko yun? So I was really, and the way, you know, the British, they do this kind of thing very, very well. And so they did it very, very well yet again. So we wish King Charles a long and happy reign.
Thank you, sir. All right, thank you.